My name is John Wilkins. I'm a statistician. And I have a few things to say to those that will one day find themselves in the position of trying to survive falling from a great height. The first thing is, your life doesn't flash before your eyes. You're probably not thinking of your wife, or your son, or your mother, or the statistics conference you're no longer on your way to. If you're anything like me, you'll be thinking about how much it's going to hurt when you hit the ground, and of what you might say to the media if you survive. Because if two things are guaranteed, they're one, pain, and two, news coverage. And you know if you do survive, the reporter is going to want you to say something profound, like how your life changed in the blink of an eye, how existence took on a new meaning, and how you're going to spend a lot more time with your kids. But really, you're not thinking about taking Jack and Jill to the park right now. What you're doing is making some serious calculations, like how long do you have before impact? 20 seconds? 10 minutes? Before the door blew open, I just finished one of those obligatory chit-chats with the co-pilot. So I happen to know I disembarked from the plane at about 43,000 feet. And terminal velocity for a human is something like 200 kilometers an hour. So if I do the math, I have around 3 minutes and 48 seconds before I hit the ground. Around the time it takes to listen to a pop song, have a quickie, sit through an ad break, smoke a cigarette. I guess it's a matter of how to best use your time. You'd better have something interesting to say if you do survive. Me, I'm gonna tell them that the way I think about time has completely changed. I came across this proverb a while ago. It went something like, "Enter the future walking backwards so you don't forget the past." As a piece of advice, I thought it was quite nice, but maybe kind of dangerous. I mean, isn't it better to stare the future in the face? Go boldly where no man has gone before? But the more I thought about it, it seemed like I'd never really had any other option than to walk backwards. I've never known for sure where I was going, or what lies in my future. Traveling through life arse first is all I've ever done. The idea occurred to me again when I was sitting in the doctor's office reading some article about the nervous system. It was saying that everything a person perceives has already happened, that there's always a time lapse involved. Like, a sound takes 10 milliseconds to reach the brain, an image takes 40, and touch takes 155. The time lapse affects all five senses. So I guess unless you're some kind of clairvoyant, everything you experience has happened at least a split second ago. Anyway, I read the article and made a mental note to think about it properly, later, sometime in the future, like now perhaps. Well, right now what I'm thinking is, it's probably not a good idea to land on my face. I should try to fall feet first onto my left side. If I hit the ground with my feet together, and fall to the left, then 8 parts of my body will absorb the impact, one after the other. Metatarsals, tibia, femur, pelvis, vertebrae, radius, humerus, clavicle. Say I'm falling at 200 kilometers an hour. Now divide that by 8 different areas of the body, and I get down to 25 kilometers an hour by the time my head hits. That's not so bad, is it? I'll still end up looking like a half-eaten turkey, but at least I'll be awake to enjoy the aftermath of my survival. And when they hit me up about the meaning of life, I'll tell them about the proverb and the time delay article. Oh yeah, and I'll tell them about the homeless guy I met outside a downtown liquor shop. He says he wasn't always a bum. He was once this kid who spent all his time in the library, reading books on quantum physics and doing mathematical equations. Later, he graduated from some Ivy League school and went on to become a scientist, a real workaholic type who dreamed of building a time machine. By the time he was in his 50s, he was a selfish prick who worked 18-hour days in a lab, had no family and no friends. But eventually, the big breakthrough came. He discovered how to build his machine. He started making money by going back and forward in time, cheating lotteries and share traders. He got rich, he got greedy, and he thought to himself, what would I do if I could live my life all over again? So he cashed up and bought gold bullion. Then he took all the gold back in time to when he was a student, gave his young self everything, and told him to get his nose out of the books and live a little. Throw parties, get women, live the high life. So the young man takes the money, quits his studies, and ends up blowing everything on drugs and women. He ends up broke, a drug addict, a bum. And a bum can't build a time machine. Okay, so the guy's story was bullshit. And it reminded me again of the proverb in the science article. Perhaps I'm a bit like the bum. I only ever fantasize about the future when I'm unhappy with how my past looks. So anyway, if I do survive, this is what I'll tell the reporters. I'm not going to give the old cliche that my life took on new meaning, and what really matters now is visiting my mother. I'm going to say, there's no such thing as the present, and there's no such thing as the future. There's nothing but the past. And the last thing I'll do is give some advice to people who will one day find themselves trying to survive a free fall. I'll say, try to fall through a swarm of migrating birds on your way down. They'll slow your descent. Or try to land in the outer branches of a tree. Keep your eyes peeled for inflatable castles, hay barns, dumpsters. Don't worry about your wife and kids right now. Just work out how much time you have before impact. Come up with a profound statement and fall to your left side. Other than that, good luck.
Watch Dust. Like this video. Subscribe for new visions of the future every week. It is the business of the future to be dangerous. Your future is dust.